proven. With that proof comes confirmation of the next, more pernicious charges of sedition and mutinous designs. These charges are all punishable by death. And at Captain Crozier's discretion, the sentence will be carried out by hanging before the men now assembled. Mr. Hickey and Sergeant Tozer will be given last words. But first, your captain would like to speak.
When we abandon ship, I promised you men two things. The first was that help was already on its way to us, back from Fort Resolution, with Lieutenant Fairholme and the party I sent out last summer. We now know those men are dead.
I found them on watch. Captain Crozier had me swear an oath of silence.
Which you broke. Now be quiet, you'll get a chance to speak. Sergeant Tozer and Mr. Morfin discovered this 2 days ago, as only some of you already know. I decided not to share it. I own that decision and would make it again. Not to deceive you, but to protect your reserves. But now we know, now we all know, no one is coming for us. We must get ourselves out under our own steam. I don't know what Mr. Hickey's plan was, but I know it didn't include all of you. And those of you who might have gone with him, I can promise you, he would have burned through you like fuel. Lied to you and used you down to your last muscle. And here's how I know. Mr. Diggle, will you open these, please, and tell the men what's inside?
It's fresh, sir.
Louder so they can all hear.
It's fresh meat.
What kind of meat?
Seal, sir.
Thank you. The other promise I made to all of you was that when we crossed paths with the Netzelik, that they would help us. Lieutenant Irving met them. And do you know what they did to him? Dr. Good, sir, would you please?
They fed him.
They fed him. They didn't cut him down and deface him. That was Mr. Hickey. They didn't slice off his man parts and punch 23 holes into his lungs with a boat knife. That was Mr. Hickey! They were no war party, those Eskimo. They were more of a family, it seemed. Four men, an old woman, and a girl. A little girl. No more than 6 years old. Mr. Hickey lied to you. Mr. Hickey lied to all of you because he needed to cut the legs out from under my leadership. And in so doing, he was prepared to set all your lives swinging. Now we will share this meat, Dr. Goodsir. But that line of help has been cut off from us now. We'll find another, no doubt. But not with gammoning dogs like this among us. Hear me, men. I take no pleasure in these deaths today. I want to bring every last one of you home. But if I cannot bring these two, then I am only doubly resolute about the rest of you. Now, before we hear Mr. Hickey's last words, I have one more request to make of you. I need volunteers to man the rope.
Come forward.
Mr. Hickey,